doesn't have the stamina. I said doesn't have the stamina. And I don't believe he does have the stamina. You need tremendous stamina.
Go see how
the bonfire with Big J Okerson and Dan Soder.
Hey everybody, it's Tuesday.
Yeah,
it's the first work day of the week since Memorial Day was
holiday
here.
Thank you for all everyone who served this country.
For real though. It is 6:09. Right on time, everybody. It must be the bonfire.
Hey, coming in late. It's your favorite slackers.
Still yet to be our fault, but in the home of satellite radio, they aren't able to find two open studios, so shows can start on time.
We are the stepchildren of it all.
Yeah.
Stepboys.
Oh, me? I've been nauseous for the past 4 days. Hey, Big J Okerson, Dan Soder, it's the bonfire.
I've had diarrhea in two different states.
Have
what
you?
Does that mean? Probably stomach cancer in my hypochondriac mind.
I don't know what, but I definitely nauseous for 4 days.
cc.com/bonfire.
If you want to see my nausea?
Yeah.
Oh,
we do a whole video. It's a new web series. We GoPro. It's just you stopping every once in a while. Go like this.
Yeah.
No, I'm okay.
I almost took
water.
A pregnancy test, but I'm afraid to find out.
Well, you gotta stop letting me bust up inside you. we gotta stop.
I mean, I'm pro-choice, but I don't want to go through it.
I know. So. I don't want to have to drive you to a different state.
I don't know. You fucking wig out and kick me down the emergency stairs here, Sirius XM.
You don't think I'll go
36 floors?
I'll go
tumbling.
Holy shit! You see that fucking head come apart, man?
I
never seen brains like that
chest.
Before. Man.
Get over here, Jay Lynn.
Jay Lynn. I told you not to let me cream pie.
How was your Memorial Day weekend, buddy?
Dude, I went and saw AEW's first pay-per-view, Double or Nothing, in Las Vegas. And it was fucking awesome, man.
Dude, you were in fucking Chris Angel's house out there.
I know I was. I was mind freak territory. I saw a couple billboards. Vegas is such a shithole.
Yeah, it sucks balls. But
it sucks so much balls. It's just
Christine likes it,
dude. I
also Christine.
You like,
for the record,
you like Vegas?
I have evidence of this. Christine
you
also
love
sucks
Vegas.
Balls.
You love all the noise and the people and the just fucking.
I don't like being in it. I've never been to Vegas as a gambler or drinker. The people watching, I think, is world class.
Let me tell you,
on the outside, like a little back from it watching.
That's
is
unbelievable.
Just
I'll give you
so
that.
Entertaining.
I'll give you that. People watching, walking. There was one night where I was like, I just walked back to my hotel and I was like, I just want to people watch. And then there was a point where that's not a good city for legal weed. Because you get high and then you're like, I don't want to fucking be here. And I was like, cling, 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 cling. And like, over here. Fucking get over here. And you're like,
why is this country so fat?
People are walking slow and people are walking fast. Also, New York pace is very unhealthy for everywhere else. So you're just like walking fast and you're just like jammed up, you know? And I'm just like, fucking. And I just got in my hotel and I was like, and it's still, I could still hear everything in my hotel. Because through your windows, you can hear like, it just.
You're a fast walker in New York. I have a question for you. Do you get stuck sometimes?
Yeah.
Where you have to
jam up?
Of course, but when you jam up, do you just accept that it's like you're darting around and a lot of people in the world are trying to see New York? Or do you start doing like the behind them, like the eye rolls and like the.
Coffee Dan gets upset. Weed Dan. Accepts it. Weed Dan's like, hey man, we're all organisms moving down the same vein.
Yeah.
Coffee Dan's like, this fucking guy needs to fucking get off his phone. If someone's on their phone, I'll be vocal about it. One guy got off the phone at 30th Avenue in Astoria and he was on his phone and it's like you're walking downstairs and he's on his phone and I go, this fucking guy.
Before you throw that stone, glass house, are you ever.
You know what I am? And by the way, I wasn't like confrontational. I was like, it was more of a this fucking guy, because he was on his phone. I'm a pull to the side of the road and text. Not always, but I try to. Never going down the stairs of a subway or up the stairs of a subway to get on my phone. Never. I can honestly say I've never once done it.
Yeah, I mean, if I feel the people around me for sure, if I feel it, like I wouldn't hold my ground. Like I'm the shit. I'd be like, oh fuck, I'm like in the way.
Vegas felt like I was constantly on the stairs of the subway. They constantly, just like the way you're moving, you're like, fuck, fuck. But then Conrad Thompson.
Here they come.
It was like a, you know, wrestling podcast coming together. Fucking awesome. It was awesome. Just seeing like a bunch of, you know, guys. Yeah, Stevie Ray, you know, from the Harlem Heat.
Mm-hmm.
I can't think of any. Conan.
You're looking for a Harlem Heat.
Fucking done for now.
Booker T, you got.
Booker T at Raw 25. Someone else met Booker T. He didn't. He made a sign.
I mean, at that point, you could bet your ass on fucking going down swinging.
This guy's hands huge, and he's still got jelly all over his towel. God damn it.
Before you tell me the answer to this question, anybody want to take a $20 bet? I say it's grape jelly. What do you think? Anybody?
Is it apricot?
Well, strawberry is actually probably the most popular.
I would say grape's more popular than strawberry. I say strawberry.
You know, as I said it, it might sound, that did sound a little bit wrong.
Yeah, it's grape
might be
grape jelly is the dominant number one jelly.
Just looking for a cheap racist joke.
Oh, okay. Just because of grapes?
Yeah, we're going to fall flat. They like their soda and their jelly grape.
Yeah. But I'll tell you, everyone likes a good grape.
Who doesn't like grape jelly?
You just start going into a
dude, we already lost Welch's.
Yeah, we lost it.
We lost Welch's maybe harder than we've lost.
We took Welch's like one of those Red Bull wing competitions, you know, where they jump off the bat.
Fuck off, dog.
Guys,
I thought Welch's
that's not the vibe I got.
We did lose them.
Oh yeah, we lost them quick.
We lost Welch's pretty quick.
Back to AEW, the StarCast was a lot of fun. It was just cool seeing a lot of like panels and different shit. Bret Hart was there, and then AEW, the pay-per-view.
That's why you don't take anything with you.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's the first pay-per-view.
Just sort of.
Yeah, it was a big thing.
Yeah, it's fucking cool, man.
I saw Chris Jericho posted a picture of himself like bruised and banged up, and was said something was like fake wrestler.
Yeah. He took a table.
Chairs hurt. Yeah, tables hurt. Yeah.
Yeah, he took a table.
How so?
Spoiler
alert.
He pulled the table out from under, and then Kenny Omega drop kicked the table first, and then hit him with it. But Kenny Omega inevitably went through the table, I think. I don't know. It was pretty good. Took a couple edibles. Gotta rewatch that, man.
Very responsible wrestling.
It is.
Very, very responsible.
Yeah, it was just a fun, cool thing to be at as a lifelong wrestling fan, and then just seeing, you know, like a new league start, because when we were kids, you had WCW. I mean, when you were really little, you had NWA.
But everything turned into something else, if nothing else. You know what I mean? It either stayed or turned into something else.
WWE.
Just kind of.
I gotta do some serious damage control.
Nitro and Monday Night Raw, and you could like switch between the two.
It was great.
It was a lot of fun. And I remember WCW saying who won the title on Raw.
Yeah.
That they gave it to Mick Foley.
Mm-hmm.
That shit's nuts. So it's cool to see AEW just as a wrestling fan. Oh, now there's competition, and hopefully it'll make both.
But as long as I keep,
You know,
hopefully,
you
know. Yeah. Step their game up.
And it was also pretty cool because we're comics, and like we got to go backstage and stuff. And it was just crazy to see like all the wrestlers walking by. And I was with Ron Funches, Dan St. Germain, and Mike Lawrence. And Jim Ross comes around the corner because he was working.
What an Ocean's 11.
Yeah, it's a real.
Holy Christ.
It's more of a pond 11. It's not a real ocean much as it is just a. It's a puddle 11.
You guys are knocking over a fucking pawn shop.
Yeah, it puddles.
And you just want the old wrestling cards.
Puddles 11. We're just going for action figures that are still in the box.
Puddles 11.
Hey,
we're the Puddles 4.
Yeah, the Puddles 4. It's me, Ron Funches, Mike Lawrence, and St. Germain. St. Germain.
Hey, buddy, Dan Puddles, you're the shopkeeper. That's it.
I'm putting it all together.
I don't know how to play right now.
I go, let's do it. And then St. Germain.
Funches, get in the air ducts.
Yeah. Ethan Webb. Hello, how are you?
I don't know. Wait, but I have to get up.
But he had a great line. JR came around the corner and we were all like, hello. And he walked by and Ron Funches goes,
how you doing?
He goes, we just got quiet.
Welcome.
Like Jim Ross was the president. We're just like, hello, sir? You know what I mean? Like, what am I, fucking doing with my life? But it's awesome at the same time. You're like, I really am just a giant idiot. Just like, who, sir?
My mind is all torn up. I can tell.
Shout out to Saul. To Sal for hooking me up with this hotel room, dude.
It always dials back to a Saul at some point.
A Saul's behind.
This is entertainment.
A Saul was behind the transaction. A Sal.
We're good? Excellent. Good to hear.
Hey, told me the story.
I'm just writing out this Blood Moon because I don't really have the structure to really go on through a attack.
And I was watching Terminator 2 just on TV.
Really?
Yeah, I was super into it, and I ordered room service.
I watched Deep Cover the other day.
Yeah, sometimes it's fun. By the way, sometimes on TV, it's I had a good time watching T2.
Oh.
You go to commercial, I go start with a bowl. Or
Christ almighty.
Holy shit,
not
you see
TV.
That fucking head come up, Bart, man?
I don't mind it.
I've never seen brains like that before, man.
I like that there's commercials, and it makes me, honestly, want to take everything from her.
Why do you like its commercials?
I have a hard time, like, committing hours to a movie.
So you need breaks?
Like a sprint.
You need breaks, little timeouts. All right.
Yeah.
I was having fun.
You know, there are breaks. It's called the fucking pause button on live television that I provided for you, you wench.
I have a follower, so I like somebody else telling me what to do.
You're a Pippin, not a Jordan. I get it.
Let's
do it.
I really got to do some work down here.
Are we saying Pippin didn't contribute? Is that what you're trying to say that?
Made a solid sneaker too, the up-tempo.
Damn right.
So I'm not necessarily wanting to
that wasn't my
that
favorite
wasn't
one.
Rebuild everything.
Black Bomb. That kind of looks like the platinum or the patent leather Jordan ones.
I like the way they are.
You know what I'm talking about. Those like were fucking great.
I like the way the arrow was written. I like the arrows.
Black Lou, how is your...
but I think the Blood Moon's over
with,
now.
White family, black family?
Got like 4 minutes.
No white family.
They don't.
Vacation,
you
streaming on Ninja's channel. I thought, oh, you're with Ninja Assassin. Cool. Yeah, Ninja's a great guy.
The white family's Winter Olympics.
I actually haven't been in his stream in a long time, though. Should probably drop by and say hello. Yeah, I remember being part of a raid on Ninja's channel when he was just like, he had nothing, like he had no viewers, and he is just starting out. And now he's grown to be quite popular.
Because he fucking threw down. God damn, he threw down a barbecue. And the food was great.
But I appreciate that. Thanks for swinging by.
What you should be doing, but
I
not
really
in, like,
need
delicate, fancy
some way to get out of here.
Yeah.
Where we're grilling,
first
like,
of all, let's just take that.
Figs with some sort of cheese. It was just like
so meat handle
slathered in barbecue sauce.
Tell you,
it was just fucking so good.
He's not a black dude, but Bobby Kelly can fucking barbecue.
Bobby Kelly will barbecue.
That guy will
barbecue a lot. I'll tell you what, at the camping thing, remember we turned it over to a couple of women that hit that grill, and boy,
how
oh boy,
does
I
one
raw sausage.
I was real queasy.
Not just two girls, two vegan girls. After I specifically was like, can one of the guys do
well,
the grill?
Vegan girl or not, you want to keep a
man.
Man,
this is
going to
be rough.
How to cook.
Yeah.
I hope they're vegan
this
girls, lesbians.
Hope they scissor when everyone else is shit puking.
I feel like we
hope you guys have plenty of time to be fucking knocking clits when I'm fucking shooting at a boat next to the goddamn.
Yeah, I'm gonna be behind this car. Really
punch you up, boy.
Good for you.
There's many of those. Get my ticket out of here. I'm the champ. You dropped me a follow too. Notification didn't go off.
You're gonna be in town?
Oh, or at least I didn't see it. Thank you.
That's the perfect view of fireworks.
It was
pretty neat.
It's great.
It's pretty neat.
It's great.
Pretty, pretty cool. Jacob, how about you, buddy? Right. How was your Memorial Day weekend? You get that young boy living in your house yet?
Joey Logano's birthday.
Do I have any wood?
On Saturday.
Yeah. Yes, I do.
Also, I tore my sports calendar for my birthdays.
And I tore it, and I saw Joey Logano, and I went like this. Jacob!
I was going through the guide one day, and nothing to watch on TV. And it was Sunday night. I was bummed. There was just like, there was no Walking Dead stuff up in there. There was nothing, no episodics. I was dying to really see. Billions came on.
Fuck, where's my bag?
And I saw the monster. Is this it? The reason I didn't have any new cartoons was Monster Energy Series.
I think I lost my shit. Uh-oh. Not good. Not good.
I never even quite got around the Billions. I don't know what happened.
I don't know why you're just going to bring this up to hurt Jacob and me.
It's a chaotic time right now. No, I want
this
to
isn't
drink
good.
Things that I love. I want to drink it in when I'm in a...
Because you can't lose two bags.
Got it. Nightmare weekend.
Yeah.
But I did wonder, did Joey Logano do well in the race?
He came in heartbreaking second.
Second?
I mean, he could have bumped Martin Truex out and won, but yeah, he came in second.
I did lose it.
Oh, yeah, he's already in the playoffs.
Playoffs?
You want to talk about playoffs?
He's already in no problem.
Yeah, he's doing really well. Killed me.
Could have won.
Could have won when you didn't want it.
Almost had.
It was his birthday weekend, too. Maybe you think he celebrated too much?
No.
I lost all my apparel.
Take that back.
You think he was having a
little bit of... I have to recreate all my clothing.
Swassing it around, being with poor, loose people,
coke off strippers,
pickpockets, communists.
I made my nephew watch
some real rebel rousers.
Oh, Joey.
I had lunch with Shane Gillis and ran into Shane on the streets of Astoria.
with your nephew?
No.
Shane, what is your nephew?
Oh, man.
He's like, who are you?
Gay.
We had poke.
You had what?
Poke.
Oh. Essentially.
I bet he ate 20 minutes after he left you again.
Yeah, at least it was just my clothing, but...
I think Shane was like, that was cute.
Poke, that's adorable.
Sucks.
Yeah, a little
that
mouse
sucks,
food.
That sucks.
Yeah. I've never had poke.
Couldn't find my bag.
You've never had poke?
Never had it.
This is
Even at a restaurant, like,
Never had it, dude.
Interesting.
What is it? It's like a fish bowl, right?
It's sushi in a bowl. That's all it is.
So it's a fish bowl.
A lot of toppings, different sauces.
I like to call shit like that a fishbowl.
It's a fishbowl. It's fair enough to call it a fishbowl.
Thank you very much, sir.
Lou. Yes. What did you do this DJ Lou? How are you doing?
Good. I took a date to on Saturday.
How'd that go? You brought it up. I didn't get laid.
I did not get laid, but she got to see the greatest comedians besides you two guys around.
This is rough, Lou.
Nice.
Bill Burr.
It was, Bill Burr was there the night before. This was Dan Natterman, Greg Rogel, Gary Goldman, Mike Vecchione, and Colin Quinn.
Yeah.
Here we go. Now we
rebuild.
She enjoyed it too much. She got a little too comfortable with the comic. Shut up, Jacob.
She did?
What? Dude,
come
did
on, she
dude.
Fucking heckle?
Dude.
No, she didn't heckle, but afterwards I took her to the olive tree upstairs, and she kind of hugged Sherrod a little too long.
You lost her to Sherrod?
No, we hung out with Sherrod small, but too long. And then
she liked him.
Yeah, but she liked the whole life. I'm like, we're civilians thing, and they're comedians. You can't take up all their time. You know, she's like, oh, do you know that table over there? Let's go sit by them. I'm like, oh boy, she's gonna be.
What did Liz? Was Liz around?
Liz was not around.
Oh boy, and Esty was around.
No Esty either. But
you don't have to call yourself a civilian in this situation, will you? Before you take a little more than that.
She was loving it too much. I didn't want to give her
No, the problem is she's already that she is a civilian. You are
drop
not.
That in there.
Saying, hey, we're civilians.
We're
I know
drop
that
this
black guy
here.
Over there really wants to fucking dick you down. You seem pretty psyched about it, so I guess I'll go civilian over here with some other civilians while you civilian over on his superstar dick.
You go person to person? I'm going to go person with those comics. And it seems like you're to go get person probably in a parked car around the corner. So have fun getting personed. I'm gonna.
So you're probably not seeing that girl again, but Sherrod definitely got his dick sucked.
I'm just gonna see Sherrod tonight at the cellar. I'm gonna be like, how was Saturday?
Money.
Money.
Got my dick sucked.
Got my dick sucked. Come smoke with me, money.
Yo, Lewitsky this shit. He brought me some pussy, money.
Yeah.
Calling me the N-word all night, and I gotta say I liked it.
You felt what? You felt down at the streets?
Yeah, it was fun.
Did you tell him your T-neck origins? You're outside.
Oh, I think he just knew.
You think he just saw that?
Yeah.
That's
he
why. That's why he thought he'd just steal your chick from you.
No, it wasn't like that. Just too civilian.
Shades.
You said too long. You felt something.
You felt there long.
I don't want to let him know that.
Do you think there was some body rock and knock in the boots? Do you think they were pressing? Do you think they were pressing up
some
on
good
you?
Love
shirt.
In the body.
I had to turn away. I don't know. I don't know what happened.
Dude, that's the one. That's the one where you gotta watch. Where there's the fucking hug, where there's the press in, you know, where there's the fucking.
Yeah.
Have you ever had that after a show where a girl hugs you, and she's like, oh,
yeah, sure,
of course, yeah,
sure, yeah.
And you're like this, you're always like, stop it.
I got so many more questions.
If they have a boyfriend, you're always like, stop it. He's a fan, and he took you to this. It doesn't. I think it's maybe happened twice. One time is when we were at American Comedy Company in San Diego. I got pressed off. And I was like,
take your guns off me, that's right.
Knock it off. This is an establishment.
I'm so heavily intrigued by DJ Lou's world. I really am. I mean, the least intriguing person is Black Lou, and I mean that in a full compliment. Black Lou just gets it, man. Just getting life.
Yeah.
Nailing it.
And meanwhile, Witzke lives in the upside
Black
down.
Black Lou takes it easy. He doesn't live his life. He doesn't Witzke live his life upset or full of anger or anything. He just fucking he rolls with the
wife.
He's the best.
You gotta crawl.
Got a wife, a life,
a family,
home.
People that love him.
Balance, nice balance.
A balance. Everybody drives a car when we're not around him.
Jacob's harboring a child.
Drives a car.
Jacob's harboring a child.
I'm gonna listen
DJ
to
Lou
else.
Is fucking. He's
something else. Stealing wood.
Holy Jesus. Are you insane? Well, I'm glad you hung
I don't know how much longer I could have done that.
Oh, Jesus.
I still think the roof fog alone was better. Yeah.
Yeah, I learned
one thing. Yeah? Hello, I'm hanging.
All right, let's do some.
3, 2, 1, I'm bored. You're speaking like the devil.
They have been making their way in. Not good.
Andrew should have been more interested if we spoke English backwards.
By the way, I hope people are drinking out there because I did a Linda Blair impression. Right, right.
Wait, what?
Linda Blair calling back.
Let's go ladder.
The power of Christ compels you! 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 The power of Christ compels you!
I don't know, why is he going back?
Ramon!
Oh, I forgot about that.
No, we don't have to talk about it. I just want to say the guy, so I showed Ant the bag of food on the floor.
Yeah, that's why we were laughing earlier. I forgot about that.
I take it that's an ixnay on the discussion A. But the guy who sent in the big book of boy stuff, Bart King.
Okay, so we ate through this.
FBI approved in the front. Federal Burping Institute.
That's funny. Oh, I missed that.
Yeah.
I threw the book
Holy
and I missed
shit.
That line.
Okay, so they got in there.
That is something. Federal Burping Institute. It's the big book of boy stuff. And I guess it's supposed to be a whole book of things that interest guys.
And they got in here as well.
Looks like a textbook.
Holy shit.
The back one's got a funny line on though.
Oh, what does it say?
It says CIA manual, but then it says CIA is craniums in adversity.
I don't get it.
I don't really get it either. I'm like, it
smells good, the book, right?
Like the first day of school. I'm going through the book and I don't really see anything I would want to read to anybody. I'd rather read more Cindy Adams.
So wait.
I'll just smell the book.
Yep.
I guess
the
they didn't get through
the
here.
The book smells good. Duda.
Indoor games.
What is it about the pocket knife that we like? They have sharp blades and they fold up and fit in our pocket.
They didn't do anything here.
And to goof around with. And of course, the pocket
man, they
tools like the
up.
Leatherman pocket survival tool are also cool. Folding pocket knives were made 2,000 years ago for Roman soldiers. These old knives had folding blades and many attachments, include.
What?
Pooping and peeing, Anthony. Some people think that you should not poop in the woods because there are plenty of logs there already. Nevertheless, when you have to go, you have to go.
And that's
and
where they fell in.
A lot louder when you're out in it. A good rule of thumb for pooping and peeing is to take care of your business at least 100 feet from camp. Peeing. Here are the most important words you will ever read. Don't pee into the campfire. The smell will be awful and everyone will hate you. Pee where nobody will be disturbed by you, but don't get lost. Think of how embarrassing that would be. If you got lost while going for a pee.
Embarrassing as having your name as author of that book.
And then he has a scenario. Father says, how did you get lost, Timmy? Timmy says, I was going to take a pee, and the next thing I knew, I was lost.
Father says, why didn't you let me go with you? Timmy says, because the last time we did that, you raped me by a tree.
Yeah.
Some male campers just keep a wide mouth jug near their sleeping bag in case they have to go during the night.
Wide mouth jug.
Thank goodness you were born a boy. Just make sure that nobody wants any lemonade in the morning.
I misread it. Wide mouth jig.
Jesus.
There's a good line here, by the way, about bullies.
Yeah.
When I was a kid, everyone was always trying to convince me that bullies were actually cowards. If you just stood up to the bullies, they would chicken out and leave you alone. And then he says, what a bunch of baloney.
Baloney. pooping. There we are. Pooping. Taking a good dump in the wilderness requires you to hunker down. This means that since you don't have a toilet to sit on, you're just going to have to pretend.
Right.
Now you're hunkering. After you're done, most good campers do a thing called cat sanitation. That means they bury their poop like a cat does. Ah.
Uh-oh.
And to do this, Anthony, you need a small shovel. Dig a hole at least 6 to 8 inches deep, hunker down, and poop into it. Toilet
hunker
paper.
Down.
If you have ever had to wipe using bark or leaves, you'll know it is not very pleasant. It's even worse if you accidentally grab some poison oak. Be sure to clean up well. You don't want to leave any dew on the lily, if you know what I mean. This could lead to bacon strips in your underwear instead of in the frying pan where they belong. As for the toilet paper, be friendly to the environment. Either burn it or bring a Ziploc baggie and pack it out with you. If you will be camping in the same spot for a while, just sprinkle some dirt over your poop so that others can reach the spot. If you're done with your poop hole, cover it up completely and run away.
Wait, Opie, there's a section in here.
Oh, my God. Where's the window?
Now, Opie, you may have thrown that too soon. You missed the section mark. Jokes! Exclamation point. Under the caption, school and studies. Father, from this report card, son, it looks like you studied underwater. Timmy, what do you mean, Dad? Father, well, all of your grades are below sea level. And then Timmy says, good one, Dad.
Hello.
How about this? To a friend who's short. Got some things for short people here. How's the weather down there? I've heard of half pints,
hey,
but
dog.
You must be a quarter pint.
How's the gig, boss?
Do you know why you aren't allowed on ships? Because you have to ride in a shrimp boat. I don't trust short people. Their brains are too near their butt. All right, Anthony, we found out who brought this to the show. How many more copies do we have to destroy?
That's it. You've got all four of them.
Steve, who gave you this?
Guy in Oregon.
Wow. Guy in Oregon sent this in, huh? Bart King?
Bart King, yeah.
He's just ripping the whole book. Just keep ripping as
one
I do.
One page at a time.
Anthony says, Dear Steve, here are some copies of the Big Book of Boy Stuff. If you're interested in specific things for the show, here's some I think that would work. Basically.
Oh, he wrote down a little list of things that'll work.
So he likes his insults chapter, which is page 153 in your workbook.
Wait,
Anthony.
Hold on,
do you still have page 153?
You bet I do. Insults, exclamation point.
All right, it starts off by...
I just realized I didn't make my compound
bow. Hold on, I'm on page 140. Let's get to 153.
Or take it with me.
Oh, there we are.
All right, it says, part of being a boy is enjoying a good insult. I say enjoying because boys know that when done properly, one of the best parts of friendship can be insulting or dissing your buddies. It's an excellent day when you can hang out with your buddies and getting some good zingers, which is true.
You little scumbag! I got your name! I got your ass! I got to get up to that page. Hold on. 151... 152. All right, here we are, 152.
All right, hey, if you can't laugh at yourself, make fun of your friends. Just
you
remember.
You are a disgusting fat body, Private Pyle.
That's a good example.
Just remember that you should only enjoy insults with friends and relatives who are in a good mood. Like practical jokes, they are not to be used on strangers or people you do not get along with. They obviously have not hung out with Club Soda Kenny, Jim Norton, Rich Voss, and the rest of the crew.
What side was that, Private Pyle?
Sir, left side, sir.
Are you sure, Private
gag?
Pyle?
Sir, yes, sir.
So then the guy has...
What?
Then you hit him in the side of the head.
Then the guy has examples of good insults that you can use
wait,
on your
wait,
friends.
What page, Opie?
154.
Oh, here I am.
You want to read the insults? Let's practice.
This one's really good.
I read the short one.
Okay.
That's what I was reading.
All right.
To friends who are short.
This one's really good.
All right, go ahead.
To friend you want to call ugly. Beginner. You're ugly. Intermediate. You're so ugly, when you were born, they put tinted windows on your hospital room.
Oh.
Advanced. Can I borrow your face for a few days while my butt is on vacation?
Wait, you gotta read the others. To a chubby friend, beginner, you are chubby.
Intermediate, you are a wonderful all-around person. It just takes a while to walk all around you.
Locks
and then the advanced person, that's really good at insults, Anthony.
Yeah?
You remind me of a map, a globe to be exact.
Oh, that's funny.
To a friend who just got a haircut, beginner line, your haircut stinks. Intermediate line.
Hey, that's the advanced line. That's what you. What do you? That's not beginner.
Intermediate line. Did a lawnmower attack you? And then the advanced line. Hey, nice haircut. Was it half price day at the barbershop?
Wow.
You're... I like in the opposite page. There's special feature ready-made insult.
Okay.
You take one word from column one,
mm-hmm.
and one word from column two,
mm-hmm.
and then one word from column three, and you call people that.
All right.
Like I'll try. You silly, rotten vermin.
One word from each column.
Right, see? I did that.
Jim, you blubbering, freakish dolt.
Opie, you crawling, wretched clod.
I'll make up my own. You AIDS-ridden fucking cunt.
I don't see those here.
No, it's on the bottom part of the page. Maybe you ripped that out.
More insults. To a friend you want to call stupid. The beginner line would be, you are stupid. Intermediate line, want to see something stupid? Look in a mirror. The advanced line, brains aren't everything. In your case, they're nothing. And if you're a genius at insults, I don't think you're stupid, but what is my opinion worth against the thousands of people who disagree with me? Well, where's that other card? I want to see what else he felt was really good in his book.
This guy sure is good.
Yeah.
He covers it.
Fuck, come on.
Oh, look at this. You can turn it inside out, the cover. It's on the front. It's a pretty funny wacky picture. When you turn it inside out, it's like a composition notebook. Like those black and white speckled
colors. You can have that and it would look like a regular book.
But your teacher probably wonder, why are you reading that and laughing?
Take
the cover off, the cover says physics. So you just have
a physics book. Your book
stinks, mister. I say we pile them in a big pile and burn them.
Yeah. Your book stinks.
Yeah, I agree. Some books should be burned.
How's that?
I think about it.
That's the beginner insult. Your book stinks. The intermediate insult is, hey, Steve, if you ever bring this horseshit to the show again, I'll rip your cock off and stick it in your ear.
All right, did we get rid of all those, all the copies?
Hello, Bart?
Hey, guys.
Have you been listening to the show today?
I unfortunately have not.
And you're done?
Second ago.
Oh. Bart, I gotta tell you something, man. We got your book.
Okay, super.
Can you give me a copy of the book?
Hold on.
All right.
Here you are, Opie.
Oh,
yeah.
Yeah, he's all tangled up.
There you go.
All right.
Funny stuff. Oh,
wait, the cover, I don't know where the cover went, Bart.
Well,
honestly, I have the, it says physics. I guess this is what the book has under it, if the cover is off.
Yeah, if you look at the dust jacket and flip it, it has like an old-style composition.
Bart, I gotta tell you, I really think that you came up with a winner here.
Ah, you guys are too kind. Thank you.
He can't
I appreciate that.
He can't hear it.
No, he came here.
He's still there?
He didn't hear the show? No.
Did
he
I
has
lose
no
you?
Idea. No, Bart, we're here.
Blow up.
Okay, sorry.
It's like a guy's how-to book.
Passing on the keys of
Oh, Piggy, you're gonna blow up too.
Yeah, Bart, I gotta tell you, I think you got some comedic licks here.
Yeah, where'd you get some of the jokes and stuff?
You know, for the jokes, I really ran back my childhood memory, and I was looking for stuff that my dad had told me when I was a kid. Wow.
You silly pig.
Yeah, my dad kind of went through it, and he said, you basically plundered all my material.
Did your dad have brain
cancer?
Sorry,
I'm picking up a weird reverb there. I hope this works out for you.
No, it's working. Is that your phone?
I guess. It's cordless. But
there's
cordless.
Some kind of static.
Yeah, sorry about that.
That's okay. We can still talk.
So what? It's a book. How would you best describe the book?
I guess I want to call it Mad Magazine, a Boy Scout manual.
That hits it right on the head, I think.
If you want ass.
Have a humorous feature chapter. Chapter on.
Yeah, explain the book a little better because we just got it and we went through a little bit of it, but we haven't really got the gist.
Yeah, I don't know.
We talked about the insults, and we thought the insults chapter was absolutely yeah, that was pretty good. Brilliant.
Well, I guess if I had one role model that I was looking towards when I read it was Joseph Scholl, and if you look at page 130, you'll see his biography.
130.
Wait, 128. Hopefully this book still has 129.
His nickname was the Fartomaniac.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Oh, yeah, okay.
The what?
The Fartomaniac, yeah. Joseph Pujol, right?
Yeah, there you go. He was kind of a Moulin Rouge performer in Paris, and apparently he was like the highest stage.
Wait, hold on. I don't know if I... Wait, what page is this?
130-130.
Excuse me, lots of fuel there.
What was he about again?
Well, apparently when he was a kid, he was swimming, and he sank. And the reason why was because water was going into his tiny den.
Oh,
he found he had the rare ability to bring air in through his rear end, and once he learned to control those muscles, he found that he could pretty much fart at will. He could make butt bongos anytime he wanted to.
Who's this, Robert Reed?
Jimmy, you're not as funny as fart. Stop trying to out-funny fart.
He had a stage act where he would make different sounds with his quarters, which included cannons, thunder, all types of dogs.
I'm sorry. Are you close to the base unit of the phone? Because I'm hearing a lot of static now.
I'm sorry. Actually, I can back off from it a little bit.
Yeah, off. Let's try that.
Yeah.
Man, I hit the jackpot here.
The hard line here.
Yeah.
How's that?
That sounds a lot better.
A little bit,
but okay. What's your favorite section in the book?
So far, it's been really good, you know. I don't know what people are thinking, but it's doing pretty well sales-wise.
Yeah, it's got to be sounding like crazy, man.
Yeah,
like
so.
Hotcakes.
Yeah, or like butt bongo kicks. Yeah, so I think that's a kind of a steering statement of the good taste of the American public, but I'll take it.
What's that?
I'll take it. If people are interested, I think that's fantastic.
Yeah, I think it's obvious you put a lot of work into
there's
this.
There's a lot of pages.
I liked your section on pooping and peeing in the outdoors.
Yeah, I have a sister who's a ranger at a federal park, and she helped me with some valuable outdoor number one and number two tips.
Yeah. Which was, if you're wiping your ass with leaves, you don't want to use the poison oak, obviously.
No, that would be horrible. And you know what's happened, too.
Really? Because we're city guys. I have no idea.
Yeah, it probably happened. But poison sumac is a distant second for, last choice to wipe the dew off the lily with.
Right, we're almost done with the interview here, so, anything else you want to say about the, the most useful chapter, would you say?
Most useful? Well, guys are always, I'm a middle school teacher, and they start getting interested in girls that age, so, I think the girls bully the chapter.
Picking the stupid chair.
What's that one about, quick, we're running.
Fuck off.
Well, looking at the girl and wondering, what was the strategy known to her? So I passed along some time-honored strategies there.
The sound people are asking for it. What do you say?
Although maybe the info project is actually the most practical one. I don't know. Just since that's where we started. Nothing better than getting a few fingers in on your friends. Alright, guys. Sorry. I'm sorry about the connection. It looks like I might have lost you.
Hello?
Yeah, I'm still here. Sorry. Hey, I'm going to go out and invest in a nice hard line. But thanks so much for having me on this morning. I really appreciate it.
Hello?
Yeah, I'm still here.
What's wrong with the phone? He's not here anymore.
I can hear you. Weird.
Hello?
Yeah.
Ben, there's something wrong with the line 10.
Hello?
I can hear you guys. Yeah.
I think he hung up.
Bart?
Yeah.
Bart?
Yeah, I'm here.
Bart?
I can hear something.
Bart?
Yeah. I can kind of hear a tinny voice far away.
I can't believe we got the author of this book on and we lost him. Bart?
Yeah. Yeah. Playwood, I'm going to hang up if anyone can hear me, and if you want to ring back, that'd be super.
Why'd he hang up, dude?
I don't know why he hung up. Did he get pissed off?
No, I didn't hang up.
Did he get pissed off? I thought the interview was going well.
I think I'm
going
to make my ears pink.
I'll even give the name of the book is Physics. Why wouldn't he want to plug Physics?
No. The cover's off that one.
Are my pants pink?
All right. Well, that was Bart. Yeah. Maybe he'll call us back.
Yeah. They're pink now.
First of all, it stinks in here now, Jimmy. Sorry.
Those were real farts. That,
oh,
was,
yeah.
That wasn't us with our stupid machines.
The three real gas ran into the mic.
He's doing the interview as his book, three copies of being ripped to shreds.
How could he not hear that ripping?
I know.
Wait, what page is that? Hold on.
He thought
How
it was,
do you not hear that?
He thought it was static.
Maybe everybody he talks to about the book, he hears that noise.
Oh, Jesus. What's with my phone?
That's a loud book.
Mr. Vital.
How you doing?
There he is. Better known as Dick Vital.
Hey guys, I can barely hear you.
God damn it.
Even Dick
phone.
Vital says
come on,
that.
Opie.
Hey, well, we're having a problem with the phones. Is this. Let me try a little something here. How's that? A little better?
A little better.
A little better?
You know, it's better.
All right, that's a complaint that everyone gives us day in and day out, but for some reason they don't know what the problem is. I don't know.
Yeah. Tough.
Where are you calling from?
I'm in Florida right now.
Florida, getting ready for the big tourney?
Yeah, I got to leave tomorrow, and I got to go to the ACC. I'll be doing 5 games there.
Very nice.
Tough work, huh?
I got to be totally honest with you. I'm usually a huge college basketball fan, and I'm not going to try to fake it. I haven't really followed it this year for some reason. Maybe because we just started this new gig at XM and I don't have the time.
Well, you're wacky. To tell them, you know what I'm saying? You're not following. You're wacky. It's been great.
Oh, I know. I
bury you on the air.
I take a peek here and there, and I was watching that game over the weekend.
Hello?
Yes, Dick.
Yeah, I just lost you guys.
Oh, boy. Oh, these technical problems. Yeah, that game.
Well, when are we gonna, are you gonna let me know when we're on?
Well, I don't know where the chicken is now.
Are you gonna let me know when we're on?
Well,
I guess it doesn't
matter.
We're on
the radio? Yeah. Yeah, we'll let you know. Yeah, we'll let you know.
Where are you guys located?
Oh, we're in Manhattan.
You're in Manhattan right now?
Yeah.
Oh, what's the weather out there?
It's a little cold. Not as warm as where you are.
I tell you, it's cold out here. My wife's complaining. It's gonna be 64.
Well, what part of Florida?
I live in Sarasota.
Sarasota, yeah.
You know, spring training, the whole bit. I love it down here.
Yeah. So what do you do when you're not, doing the college basketball?
I do a lot of speaking. I do a lot of, in fact, as soon as the season ends, I'm with the Washington Speakers Bureau, and I do a lot of motivational speaking around the country for various corporate groups, et cetera. So keep busy, and I've written, not bad for a guy that can't read or write. I got 7 books.
Yeah. Do you play golf or anything like that?
Yeah, no, I do. I play a lot of tennis. Play golf, and... I'm not good at golf at all. I'm a much better tennis player, but I live on a golf course down here in Florida. It's called Lakewood Ranch Country Golf.
Yeah, sure. Well, I guess we got about another minute. We're going to start the interview. So. What do you think about LeBron James so far?
He's phenomenal. You know, he's terrific.
Better than Jordan, you think?
He's going to be in that category when it's all said and done, but he has to win yet. He hasn't won, you know, and obviously he's really young. But that's the one thing that Jordan did and did so well. He was such a big-time winner. You know, getting stats is one thing, but time will tell. I mean, he's only 20 years old. Jordan didn't win until he was like 26 or 7. So.
Well, and he's got to get the supporting cast like Jordan.
Exactly. He's got to get the cast around him. And seems under good
care. Right. I got to take something for this. I'll be right back in just a moment.
Tough not to get carried away when you're making that kind of cash.
Yeah. Don't you think?
Hey, I'll tell you what I'd like to say, man. I'm tired of those New York papers burying Alex Rodriguez, calling him the most hated player. Players don't like him. Hey, it's one reason. I happen to know Alex well. They're jealous of the kid.
Of course.
They call him a con man. Con man because he's nice. He cares about his image. You don't read about him with drugs, alcohol, steroids. I mean, I find that very frustrating.
That's the New York, papers. You know, the sports guys are animals.
But you guys are heard all over the country.
Oh, yeah. It's a national show. We're almost back from break here. It's amazing, you know, getting back to the LeBron James thing where they're trying to tell these guys they can't go into the NBA. You know, these high school kids.
Yeah, it's tough. He's so different. Yeah.
Yeah, but don't, I mean, if you have the opportunity to make millions of dollars in the NBA, why shouldn't you?
Well, you know, a kid like that is unique and certainly special, but there's so many others that make that journey that aren't ready for it. I mean, he's a rare, like a Tiger Woods or like a Serena Williams. There's some rare people that just have great, great talent, but when you look at the majority, aren't in that role. And unfortunately, there are a lot of kids who think they're LeBron James.
Well, it seems like I think the colleges are afraid because they're going to lose a lot of good players.
I'm telling you, man, I am having a tough time.
Yeah,
I hear you in spurts, you know. I hear key words like LeBron James.
We're trying to work out the technical glitches. That's why we haven't, started yet.
You can't get louder, huh?
Yeah, this seems to be a problem. I don't know if we're going to have to reschedule or something.
Is that? Can you hear now? Is this possible for you to hear?
Well, that's better now.
Maybe I might have been speaking too late. I was saying that it seems like the colleges are really worried that, like, these young players are going to wind up just skipping college and going right to the pros.
Oh, yeah, that's a big dilemma. It's a big problem.
I mean, it just seems like it's kind of hard for someone to pass up that kind of money, man. Because if you're in high school, all of a sudden a team is like, well, you know, we'd
really
like to.
Yeah, and most of these kids come from socially disadvantaged situations where, obviously, in a stroke of a pen, they change their whole life for their family.
All right.
Well. And one understands that.
Good point. Can you hear us now?
Yeah, I hear you better now.
All right, because I think we're getting ready to go back into the show.
Okay. Are you guys on live right now?
And we're back with the Opie and Anthony program, the ONA virus spreading across America, thanks to XM Satellite Radio. On the phone line, we got Dick Vitale. Hey, Dick.
How you doing, guys?
Hey,
going on, man?
There he is. What's going on? It's been a long time since we've talked to you. I think we talked to you once on the old show back at WNEW.
Well, let me tell you this, man. I know you've not been following college hoops like you should, and you've missed a heck of a lot. Let me tell you, it has been absolutely phenomenal. This year probably better than in the last decade because so many kids came back to school and didn't go chase those crazy dreams thinking about the NBA. We had so many great players return, like the kids in Kansas and North Carolina. It's just been a phenomenal year. And March Madness is going to be absolutely awesome, baby.
Yeah. And I got to tell you, I've been following college basketball this year like no one's business, man. And I think you're right because a lot of these guys didn't jump to the pros, you know. So these college teams are all stacked with a lot of talent.
Yeah, you're right there. There's no question. Opie and Anthony, let me tell you something. I got fired in the pros because my guards look like you two suckers, man. And that's why I got the Ziggy.
Yeah, I got to tell you, man. Kentucky, Duke, Wake Forest, North Carolina, Illinois. Could be anyone's tournament this year, huh?
Well, I think it's about a dozen teams that can win six games in a row. I think there are a lot of teams, you know, could go on and win two games and get to the Sweet 16. But then you start to separate them when you talk about winning six in a row and being a national champion. You just right now hit some of the great ones. Right now I look at some of the number one teams will probably be Illinois, Wake Forest, certainly North Carolina. And I think Kentucky might sneak in and get a number one seed.
Yeah, I'd have to agree with you. Syracuse, a long shot, I'm thinking, this year, but they're in it again.
Well, no, Syracuse is a very dangerous team with that 2-3 zone, and certainly if Jerry McNamara and Hakeem Warwick, a great tandem, if they get any help, they need a third guy to step up and be big and score consistently.
Tell me about it. They could, that kid that comes off the bench.
Boy.
Robert?
Yes, Robert.
Look around.
A guy like, well, Pace is certainly
sell some
a guy
stuff.
Give a point production, but they need somebody to help, certainly their big two, and they can create problems. I think Connecticut's as hot as anybody, and the reason is Marcus Williams is probably the most improved player in America. He has really improved with the guard spot, and their front court for Jim Calhoun has been sensational, pulling a wave up Boone and certainly Rudy Gay.
Yeah, and with him, shooting those jumpers from the outside, it opens up the middle for the dude on Connecticut there.
Yeah, I tell you what, you know your hoops, man.
Yeah, I know.
Oh, shoot. You know what? I didn't even take my money with me.
The floor, then he can get the ball in the middle to, what's the guy's name on Connecticut? I can't believe it. Yes, of course.
Yep.
And what do you think of Gonzaga this year?
Gonzaga is very, very dangerous basketball team. Certainly no longer a surprise team, but a team that certainly is going to create problems again and very talented and just won their conference tournament over a really good St. Mary's team. And I'm telling you, St. Mary's is good. They won 25 games. I hope the selection committee considers and certainly puts them in a tournament they deserve to be in.
Sure. Yeah, Gonzaga, I believe they're rated 10th in the nation now.
Yeah, they're up there high. And
this is all stuff they actually need.
Gratitude.
safe travels, friend.
Get a few jobs.
Win the national title or even get to the final four from the
can
non mega conference. And they're one that can. The last time it happened was like in
79.
Larry Bird. We had the Magic Man there and we had certainly
I think I can level up, right? Yeah.
Was there as well.
Yeah, it's gonna be a very, very exciting tournament this year.
Hey Dick, the injuries are gonna hurt Boston College.
Boston College is certainly a club that, you know, has been a real surprise. In fact, Al Skinner would be my National Coach of the Year on my awards. He's done a phenomenal job with that program and certainly a dangerous basketball team. But I just wonder about their guard play. If it's good enough to be able to march on to get, you know, when we talk about that special place at the Final Four.
Yeah, I hear you. You know, not many people are talking about Maryland this year.
Well, you know, Maryland's right now, you know, hanging and hanging by a thread.
Barely, right?
They may be playing the NIT, man, for the NIT championship, unless they get some wins. They got to play Clemson tomorrow in a tournament down in the ACC, and that's a must game for them because they've lost their last three in a row. And the bottom line is they need a win badly. They're 7-9 in conference play. I think if I were on a committee, and it's truly the 34th best at-large teams that get selected after the 31 automatic berths, there's no one in their right mind could convince me that Maryland and Georgia Tech aren't two of the best 34 teams that are there. But again, you look at 7-9 in conference play, that becomes scary in the eyes of the tournament people that select.
But Dick, are the injuries going to hurt Georgia Tech this year in the tournament?
Well, you know, the injuries hurt them earlier in the year, but now they got everybody back. And Georgia Tech, a club that I think will be in a tournament. They had the big win over Clemson for them. That was major. And over Miami. So they're sitting at 8-8. And I think they'll be in a tournament. And they're one of those dangerous teams if they're a number 7 or 8 seed.
Some interesting ish houses, but nothing I want to waste time on right now.
That would be a dangerous spot.
Absolutely. Yep. Dick, who do you think has the heart of a champion this year?
I think the champ's going to come out of Chapel Hill. I really do. I think that when I look at North Carolina this year.
No, the house might be in the snow.
Their year to celebrate. I think Roy Williams is going to finally get that national title that has just escaped him down in Kansas. I like this club. I like their offensive ability. I like the commitment to the side on defense. I love the combination of Feltman and May. They got a great freshman in Marvin Williams, the magnificent one, Marvelous Marvin. I tell you, I really like North Carolina. Don't count out Duke, obviously. They got some tough kids, well-coached, and they got J.J. Redick, who I would right now, if I would cast my ballot today, in fact, I'm casting it today for the John Wooden Award. And my ballot, I'm telling you guys first.
I'm going to kill you.
Anthony, the National Player of the Year. I'm going down to Durham, North Carolina. And I'm going, yes, past the envelope, J.J. Redick.
Oh, without a doubt. Oh, yeah. I like the point. You know, but some of the fellas on Illinois.
I fucked that up.
Something to say about that.
Yeah, they got a great guard combination. I'll tell you
what. I
got to
tell you.
What a threesome. And Williams and Brown and certainly Luther Head. All three have been dynamite all year. Lost that heartbreak at Ohio State, but they accomplished their first goal. That was the Big Ten championship, and now they're chasing the Big Ten tournament.
Dick, we got some instant feedback here. Someone's talking about Duke being a good team, but they're saying that the injuries, man.
The injuries to Duke?
Right. Well,
I can barely hear you now, OB.
No, that was Norton. He was talking about the injuries to Duke, but
yeah, you know, it was Sean Dockery, and that's what's going to hurt. But they got the big three when you talk about Redick and Ewing and Sheldon Williams and good support players. And Lee Melchione has been an incredibly improved player and really has come on big, giving them a three-point threat. So they've been able, as long as they can put support players around those three, they got a chance to win. And they got kids that play so hard. Watch Arizona still coming out of the West. Arizona is
probably heard that over the mic.
Basketball team. Salim Stoudemire's had a phenomenal year this year. He's just done really a great job, especially a clutch. And Lute Olson knows how to win. I mean, the guy's a big-time Hall of Famer and knows how to win. So Arizona, you know, Washington's going to be very dangerous, very explosive.
Yep.
So the Pac-10 is a lot better this year.
Yeah, the Big East isn't really representing this year that much, but
well, Connecticut, Syracuse, I'll tell you, the Big East is a very deep conference, maybe the deepest in America. In fact,
10,
I think you're going to see
12,
seven teams are going to come out of the Big East.
You are. Well, how about this, Dick? The Final Four.
My Final Four, you guys put me on the spot big time, man. I haven't seen the draw, but right now I'd go with probably Illinois, Wake Forest, North Carolina, and I'm not sure the fourth. See, I don't go to the RPI, guys. I
go to the Vital Ball Dome Index. I go right to my ball dome, my BBDI, and it has not been able to give me a 14 yet. I have three, but I can't get the fourth. I have to wait till these tournaments play out at all these conferences. So right now, the BBDI is telling me, Dickie V, wait a minute, baby, and you guys better go get FHM. Go get that magazine, because they did a feature on me in that magazine. And don't you dare to look at the other side of where they did the article on me. See, the problem is, nobody's going to read my article when they go to the other side. Oh, there you go.
All right, well, you said it all. Well, what is that article about?
It's all about the tournament.
Yeah, yeah.
All about the tournament, Q&A, about working in television. I hope you guys have seen my DiGiorno ad flying through the air.
I gotta tell you, hilarious.
And the DiGiorno pizza, there's a guy 65 and 12, Duncan. Remember what I told you? It's not delivery, it's DiGiorno, baby. Well, I got a new one coming out with a Pontiac that's gonna be a lot of fun coming out on Sunday.
The fuck?
And then I got one with Hooters that's a lot of fun when I'm going fishing. And the Hooter girl says, I just want
more than you, Jimmy.
Oh, man, she really hurt me, man. She caught a nice large mouth, but I'm so happy with the Hooters people because they've donated over $300,000 to one of my favorite charities in memory of my buddy Jim Valvano, the Jimmy V Foundation for Cancer Research. And guys, if you could just simply help us out, we're trying to raise money for battling cancer. Just anybody that would like to help us, call 1-800-4-JIMMY-V. 1-800-4-JIMMY-V, and let's beat that disease that comes after all of us. Whether we're rich, we're poor, we're black, we're white, we're Catholic, we're Jewish, it doesn't matter, man. It comes after all of us, and the only way we're going to beat it is by raising dollars.
All right, Dick Vitale, it's always a pleasure.
Hey, guys, you want to find out more about the tournament?
Yeah.
Go to my website. Just go to DickVitaleOnline.com every day. I put up who the teams to watch, all kinds of information about the tournament. Make sure you go to my website, and make sure when you go there, Opie, I know you need it. You better buy a Dickie V alarm clock to wake you up in the morning.
Now, you plug for.
Go ahead, Jimmy.
Dick, you're picking Wake Forest. A lot of people are not picking them to go as far as you are.
Well, you know, Wake Forest, a lot of people are going to get bumped out because they don't defend really exceptionally well. They rely on their offense. But something tells me they're going to respond in the tournament and play on a defensive side as well.
But what about the injuries to the defense?
What's about what?
What about the injuries to the defense?
Well, you know, you said something about their defense, right?
The injuries to the defense.
No, their defense really is a situation where they just got to make a commitment. If they focus defensively, I mean, they got themselves a heck of a cast of players. Chris Paul is as good as it gets in the guard slot. In fact, I laid under my All-American team, just gave him a player of the year. Chris Paul will be my point guard. J.J. Redick, my scoring guard. Akeem Warwick will be one of my forwards from Syracuse. Wayne Simeon will be my other forward. And we're going from that to the man. Remember this name, Andrew Bogut, 7 foot from Australia, has been absolutely super for Utah. Now look, I even gave you my all-star, my all-American NFL team.
I hear
you. I gotta get a T.O., baby.
Dick, the only problem is Connecticut's guarding the perimeter. Can they do it?
Yeah, they can guard the perimeter.
A little bit. Dick, I thought I knew a lot about college basketball, man, but you embarrass me every time.
No, that's not true. I wish I had your nice youth, your cash. Loan me some cash, man. I heard you guys are breaking the bank.
Well, yeah, we make a lot of money, and we got big ones. So.
Well, then just make a nice check out to the Jimmy V Foundation for Cancer Research, will you?
There you go.
Hey, let's not forget about that kid Ewing, though.
Yeah, not bad.
He's very impressive. I think he's going to do a lot in this tournament. So.
All right, man. I got to go.
All right, Dick. Thank you. Right, Dick Vitale, everyone. Oh, Dick. Dick.
Yeah, I hear you.
Oh, my God. He's good. It's a switch. It's a switch with him. God, was that funny.
Yeah.
You're on. Hey, how you doing? Yeah, baby.
Remote. All right, we got to say hi to Kelly Hansen. Kelly, what's going on?
Hey, what are you doing?
How are you, buddy?
I'm brushing my teeth.
You're brushing your teeth. Why?
Yeah. Well, you know, sometimes stuff gets out here.
Where are you calling from?
I'm in Atlantic City.
Oh, okay. You are the new lead singer of Foreigner.
Yes, I am.
That's really, now, that is probably a hard thing to do. I would think, very hard to replace the singer.
Well, you know, I try to look at it this way. Listen, I do the best I can do. I put my own thing on it, and I'm not trying to be anybody else, because that would be way too difficult to try to be somebody else.
Yeah, you're singing all the
hey,
old
Blake,
famous.
Hey, Blake, where are you going?
Absolutely.
Yeah, and you got to have pretty good range for that, right?
Yeah, it's challenging stuff. Yeah, absolutely.
Uh huh. So you're getting a good reaction out there, huh?
Absolutely.
Yeah,
it's phenomenal.
Right. We got a lot of people.
Phenomenal.
We got a lot of callers that are very excited. They want to go and see you guys, I guess.
All right.
Let's say hi to Steve in Yellowstone. Steve in Yellowstone.
Hey, Steve.
He's very excited.
Oh my God.
Steve, go ahead.
It's flopping.
Hello. I'm I didn't think I was going to get through. I'm sorry. I'm a little bit nervous.
All right, go ahead,
loosen
Steve.
Loosen your pants a little bit.
Yeah, calm down,
right.
Steve from Yellowstone. Let's
I'm
go.
Sorry. I just did. I'm a little bit embarrassed. My people in my office are kind of laughing at me because I'm calling a radio show to talk to somebody.
Yeah, you're a big Foreigner fan?
Yes, I grew up listening to Foreigner. I grew up.
Listening to a Foreigner, and you like Lou Gramm. Have you
not
heard Kelly?
Not a decent amount of XP from this.
Yeah. He sounds just...
Ramon! Kelly is a girl!
How are you? Here you go, friend. Whatever you need, just say the word.
Steve sounds a little...
Ramon! Lou Gramm! Baggage! Somebody didn't take their medication this morning.
Yeah, that's what it sounds like.
Yeah.
Wow.
Ramon! This guy sucks dick.
All right, Steve. I think we've had it with you. Kelly, I'm sorry. Sometimes you get callers that get through and
they just want to be silly.
We'll
beat
asses.
That out. We'll beat that out.
Ramon! You know, that is your crowd, though.
Yeah, unfortunately, that is a few of them. A few bad apples, as we like to call them. Wow.
Don't file a whole bunch.
All right, let's say hi to Ben in Boston.
That wasn't him?
Ben in Boston, you're on with Kelly Hansen, the new lead singer of Foreigner.
Hey, dude.
What's up,
yeah.
Ben?
Yeah. Dude, what are you guys playing in Boston?
When are we playing in Boston?
Wants to know when you're playing in Boston, Kelly.
Much obliged, stranger.
Well, we're not there. I met Lou Gramm one time. Dude, I met Lou Gramm one time. He was doing a call for Tom Brady. He was doing what? He was doing porn with Tom Brady.
Tom Brady from the Patriots, I guess.
Yeah, we don't know if Lou Gramm did blow with Tom Brady. That's just Ben's opinion.
Caller seems very ill-informed.
Yeah, exactly.
Ben from Boston. Ben, you still there?
Yeah.
All right. Okay, let's sell that.
Do you have a real question for Kelly?
Yeah. No, we don't have no one today. We have Lou Gramm, Mark Bruno.
Sounds like he's spinning around on a wheel.
He probably is. All right, thank you, Ben from Boston. All right, we got one more question because we're running out of show here. It's Eric from Brookhaven. Let's say hi to Eric. Eric, what's up?
Hello?
Eric.
Hi, can I speak to Kelly, please?
Kelly's on the line.
Hey, man. How you doing?
Good.
Cool. How is the touring with the band and stuff?
What's that?
How is the touring with the band? You sound exactly like you, man. It's great.
We're having a great time. The crazy thing is that this summer we're not even
maybe
on
I should
the
just
we're
take
like
up another
flying
job.
Everywhere because we just started in March. So it's like I have seen more airports than you can believe.
But
it's a great time with the band. About hanging out,
right.
Just really great.
Is I know well, do you like how eloquently I answered that question?
Yeah, wow, that's pretty good.
No, it's a... Oh, no!
Can you help me with my problem? Thank you. I bet you wouldn't.
Is there... Did the screener didn't pick up that this was Steve again?
Oh, I'd rather listen to Gary Glitter's computer collection. Ramon, I've heard better sounds coming out of Adam Walsh's hat. Well,
look, Steve. Steve, you've had your fun. There, you're a star for the day, Steve.
Ramon, this guest sucks.
Are you happy, Steve? You got on again.
Ramon, bring me a cover band.
All right.
Ramon.
All right, we get it.
Well, thank you, sir.
Whatever he's having.
Check back soon.
All right, thank you. Well, Kelly, you sound great. And where are you guys playing? Atlantic City?
Yeah, we're playing at the House of Blues in Atlantic City.
Nice.
We're playing there tonight, actually.
I mean, you sound just like, Lou. It really is amazing. Continued success for you guys.
Well, thank you very much, and I appreciate you guys taking the time. So.
No problem, man. All right.
I mean, you woke me up, but what am I going to do?
No, yeah. You did great.
Go play some cards.
Jimmy, where were you? We've been on
What's
the
that?
Phone. No, one of our guys just came back in the studio.
Let's say hi to Scorch in Syracuse.
What's up, boys?
The it's kingdom Scorch. Of nakedness.
It's the naked militia now, Opie.
No, it'll always be known as the kingdom of nakedness.
Naked militia, he's upgraded.
What's up, guys?
Are you, you're a hamburger, right? No, you're pizza?
No, I'm pizza. I was saying, no, you're hamburger. I'm hamburger. Yeah, I think I might have been pizza, but they wanted burgers.
They wanted,
oh boy.
Best pizza ever, but they wanted hamburgers.
And you know what? God damn it, I still am.
Scorch is a friend of the show and has always been a friend
always
of the show.
Always been.
He wasn't an
I am dealing with the most intense heartburn right now.
Yes.
It's not even based off anything I ate.
That's terrific. Hey, that's terrific. Scorch does mornings in Syracuse.
Yeah, where are you, Scorch?
Going down the toilet after that.
What station?
Rock 105, the dog.
The dog.
Rock
the dog.
Dog. Of course, the naked militia.com as well. Sign up for that. Talk to these Oompa Loompas.
Okay, so many feathers, but I'd like some eggs too, please.
I've got the original Oompa Loompas, Malcolm and Rusty.
Are you sure they're real Oompa Loompas? Because we know that there were a couple of imposters out there.
No, these guys are real. They
like Wizard of Oz midgets. They run around saying that they're Wizard of Oz midgets when they're really not.
No, these guys are Oompa Loompas. They are original Willy Wonka midgets. So. Why don't you talk to them, Shady?
How old are they now?
Well, good morning. How are you?
Oh, they're from England.
My name is Rusty, and I was an original Oompa Loompa, and I'm just over 50 years of age, and I've got Malcolm Dixon here. Say hello.
Could you
sing us a piece of the Oompa Loompa song?
Oh, that was great. Oh, yeah.
Okay. Oompa Loompa, Loompa Dee Doo, I've got a perfect Oompa for you. Oompa Loompa, Loompa Dee Doo, say hello to Opie and Anthony. Yes.
Oh, look at that.
I
thought it was kind of cute because it was like I actually had no idea you were going to do that. So what do you guys do now besides like just kind of just tour and stuff like that?
Yeah, we're here for an event in Oldham at we're going to meet two Munchkins.
Oh, there's still Munchkins alive? Yes. Speaking of the Munchkins, I got to tell the guy here. David Spade's new show on Comedy Central. He played some audio clips of the Munchkins walking.
Yeah.
Holy shit, we got to get the audio.
Really?
Yeah, they did a whole press tour where they were on GMA and all this. Oh, are you guys live with us?
Oh, you had to dump out?
I didn't know we were like simulcasting today, Scorch. You guys
sorry, Scorch.
No, that's okay. What the fuck do I care?
No,
oh,
you
can't. Was I live this show? I'm sorry.
All right, just tell us not to curse. Are we live in Syracuse?
No, yeah, you are, but that's okay.
Oh, I'm sorry. You should call me.
Man, it's all good. What the hell? I don't have a license after today anyway.
No, this is our satellite radio. We can curse and stuff. That's why satellite radio much
much cooler than commercial radio.
That's why I'm coming to XM Star Jingle.
Oh, are you really?
We'll talk. Anyway, what else is going on? Talk to these guys.
Shut up, old nut. What's that, Scorch?
Kingdom of Nakedness.
Naked Militia.
You want to talk to,
Stop being an idiot.
One of which, we got Steve. Is that Steve?
Yeah, we got Steve on the phone.
We're national, so we're all over. This call is coming from Yellowstone.
Yes, fan of the movie, so let's see if I can make this work here.
Oh my God. Hello. Hi. Are these guys hostage, or are you for real?
We are for real.
We are for real.
Come and see us in Auburn, New York on tomorrow and Saturday at 10K Hardware, 76 State Street. We will be there. You can come and catch us if you like. I'm just talking to the chicks there.
I am actually a very big fan. Oh my God, are you the only two Oompa Loompas or are there more?
There are three guys that are still alive. And then there's one girl that's in a Twilight home in England.
Genetic disaster. What was the last one? He stepped on you.
Yeah. I know I said
it started Ramon.
Bring me. I will bring you talking pieces of shit.
No, we got that one.
Oh wait, Ramon. Yeah. Bring me a spoiled family photograph.
Yes. No, we got that one. There was one about AIDS that I didn't quite.
Oh, push. Ramon, Oompa Loompas have AIDS.
Scorch is a pretty brave broadcaster. He didn't panic in his voice.
Yeah.
Because he just decided to simulcast us today, and those curses were going out. Damn, is that funny?
Over the airwaves.
Hey, fuck it. Scorch goes out in a blaze of glory. Naked Militia. Russ!
Yeah.
Hey, Russ, how you doing? Welcome to the Greg and Tony Show. How are you today, sir?
Doing pretty good.
All right, you got this book out, huh?
Oh, yeah.
We've been enjoying your book, sir. Yeah, did you read it? That's right. A little, might I say, a little risque.
Just a little.
Just a bit. A couple of things kind of spun my head around a couple of times. Yeah. You know what I mean?
Oh, yeah.
Everything you know about sex is wrong.
Russ?
Yeah.
That's the title of the book.
Yes.
Yeah.
Just to let you know, we do a very family-oriented radio show here, so we got to keep it kind of between the lines, if you know what I mean.
Oh, is that right? Okay.
Well, when we were approached by our producer about having you on with this book, we kind of, we were a little leery about it, to tell you the truth, because it is very explicit, and this is a family-oriented show, and we were trying to figure out how to actually touch on some of the subjects.
Okay, well, tell me what you figured out. How could we touch on this?
Well, why did you put this book out? What were you hoping to gain?
let's see. Well, I've been doing all these anthologies for the...
Hey, that's not a bad word, is it? Anthology, you know. Go ahead, Russ, go ahead.
I've been doing these anthologies for the disinformation company in New York, and, you know, we've been doing kind of unthemed ones. They just were all over the map. They covered sex, but they also covered current events.
Right.
History, and, you know, often,
right.
You know, but the angle always was things that are, you know, controversial or hidden, stuff like that. And so we decided it was time to do a themed one. And what better theme than sex? I mean, there's just so much...
Sex sells, doesn't it, there?
Yeah, but there's such a preoccupation with sex in this country, I think. And I think it might be hurting our children. What do you think, Russ? What do you think?
No, I don't think so. I think kids are going to be just fine somehow.
Let me ask you a question, Russ, because you're talking about, like, a lot of the popular myths that might be wrong, but do you think that a lot of what kind of goes into pop culture as far as whether it's a sexual intonation or writhing around or things of that nature, I mean, do you think that kind of contributes, or is that basically what a lot of people would say is a non-factor?
It's kind of a mix. I mean, popular culture does, you know, keep some of these myths
going.
Wasn't
too far away.
And, but in some other ways, I think.
No, but I mean, like, I'd probably rephrase that. I mean, like, in the direct contrast to what is normally considered relative sexual.
That's normally considered what?
Like, relative as far as sexuality.
Right.
Because what I'm saying is, like, a lot of what happens in pop culture, people look at it and they say, well, that's not really relative. So what I'm saying is, can you make a direct connection, or do you think that it kind of deviates from what people would normally expect, but not, you know?
You mean, does it really apply to, like, what people are doing?
Because what happened... I was leaping through it, and there was some very interesting things here, like things that you think or things that aren't true. And I've always found that, like, what popular belief will sometimes go against the grain, and yet it's not completely or totally incorrect, but by not different standards, if, you know?
Well, sure, sometimes, yeah, there can be a grain of truth in things.
No, but I'm talking about with...
Go ahead, Jimmy.
Yeah.
Hold on, I lost the page here. I'm sorry, buddy.
There
I had a page.
It is.
Wait, hold on. You have the book in front of you?
Yeah.
Good. 118.
What is this? Perfect about a girl. This actually was kind of... What I liked about this story is it's going one way, but then it goes another.
Yeah, this is actually about... it's written by a woman who gets this erotic charge out of popping pimples.
But here's what I gotta ask you.
Mm-hmm.
How much of this would you say is it fact, or is it like, are these like, this is what I was saying about like relativity and pop culture. Are these things kind of things that really happen, or did you just kind of hunt it out and find it?
Well, everything in the book, it's all nonfiction. It actually happened.
So
at least, you know, that's what the people who wrote it are saying.
But now, does she get, like, a real thrill out of popping the zit?
That's what she says, yeah.
How do you know?
It's kind of a turn-off. And what really grabbed me about this particular essay is that I've actually known women, have been involved with two women, who had the same kind of thing.
Wait, hold on. Dude, page...
This can go.
Women do love popping. Hold on. What page is this? 130?
118.
Yeah, 118.
Oh.
Yeah, that's... I read that one, and I gotta tell you, I was a little put off. I can't imagine there's a woman out there that would enjoy this kind of thing.
Yeah, there is. I mean, this is... It's not only her turn on, but I've actually known two women who like this too.
Now, do you find that is it the fact that they're like popping zits, or is it something like where you like deal with like a kind of like a thing, but yet when you're looking at it from another point of view, it's kind of like, well, I'm going to take this one thing and go in the opposite direction because, you know, I mean, it's like there's a whole book about, you know, if not from that.
Well, that's, I don't know, that's a good question, and
certainly, yeah.
Exactly what, you know, what you get is kind of left for the leaders to decide.
Yeah, yeah, exactly. Hey, I want to get, let's dive into some terminologies here I'm getting from the book, and see if you can clear some of these things up.
Try to
keep it a little clean.
What page?
What is a 126?
Okay.
What is queening?
Okay, that is more of a popular activity in Europe and Britain, and that's where a woman will actually sit on a man's head.
Oh, easy now, Russ. I want to know what this is, but we, you know, like I said earlier, please let's keep this civilized. Queening.
Mm-hmm. Well, that's it. But
just her sitting on. Now that doesn't sound very shocking.
Yeah, you do that when you're a kid. You wrestle around. You have pillow fights.
Little sitting on the head. That's fine.
You're rocking around the back of the van. He comes back.
Anything else involved with queening?
No, actually, that's the interesting thing is that it doesn't involve what you might think it would involve.
Ah. All right. How about the cytophilia?
Yeah, that's just a general term that applies to any way that you can use food for a sexual purpose. And I think, you know, the most obvious way would be, you know, bananas and cucumbers and these kind of things.
What?
Let's go to page 120, Anthony. 120.
Hold on.
What is kibaza?
Ah, yes, that, well, let's see, how to keep this clean. That's,
yeah, please. It's a bring your kids to work day here today, and I have my young son here in the studio with me, so if you could please keep this, you know, above board.
Page 120?
Yeah, kibaza.
I don't have that one.
125.
I don't have that either. 118 to 145, of course.
Yeah, kibaza is where a woman has developed the ability to grip with her
Whoa, wait a minute now. To grip with the private area.
Yeah.
All right.
Grip what?
Grip like a could she grip? Could she bring me a beer? You know, like bring me a beer or something.
For what's
cover your ears, son.
We're having fun like men talk here today. We don't have the hole in here with us today. Betty Hole, she's our co-host usually.
Yeah.
But we just call her the hole. Still there, Russ?
Yes, any other terms that you're interested in?
Yeah, I'm fascinated with some of the terminology in this book, but I'm just thumbing through it right now.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, there she is. The hole.
Well, what about page 120?
Let me get to that one. I've always been bad with finding page numbers, Russ. Explain that before. Oh, jeez, look at the title of this.
How do we?
I can't say that.
How do we explain this, Russ?
That's a good question.
Let's see how good you are at doing radio.
Wow.
Well, let's see. It was written by a woman who used to do phone sex professionally. And she noticed, you know, the phone sex company had their ads in the back of Hustler and Gallery. And men's magazine.
Uh-huh.
And she started noticing that a lot of men were calling and wanting her to give them these fantasies that involved other men.
You know, you're right.
Yeah.
Yeah?
Well, Betsy does agree.
Okay.
I could really use some help, Fred. Thank you.
I'm trying to figure out how we can really get a little more detailed without going over that line. You know what I mean?
Oh, yeah, I know what you mean. I'm
just call it the Sea Sucker Magnet.
Oh.
Come on, stop.
Don't worry about it.
honestly, you gotta stop.
Yeah.
He just said sea sucker magnet. That's all.
You guys have to stop.
Yeah, Betsy gets a little annoyed. So what is that about?
Well, yeah, it's about the phone sex woman who noticed that lots of men...
Wait.
Now, Betsy, let him finish the story. He hasn't said anything dirty yet. Go ahead, sir. I'm sorry.
Well, yeah, all these men were calling. Apparently...
Now, hold on.
All right, hold on. 2 seconds. Take me off the air, OP. Take me off the air. Hey.
Yeah.
Cunt. Shut the fuck up and let the guy talk. Fucking bitch. I put me back on. Hey, Russ, how you doing? I'm sorry. Betsy, you know, we have a little tension here in the studio sometimes, and Betsy gets a little out of hand, but, so now this magnet, is about a phone sex, thing?
Yeah, it's written by a woman who used to do this professionally.
Wait, no, come on!
Hey, Betsy, let Russ talk, okay? Betsy?
And she noticed that all these guys calling in, well, a lot of them.
No, it's not funny.
We're wanting these fantasies with other men.
Yeah. I have to apologize for Betsy talking over you. Anytime we try to we've tried to bring a little bit of sensuality into the program, because we're so mainstream. But Betsy really doesn't enjoy this, and we just have to. Acclimate her to what's going on in the world. Hey, enter this century, right?
Boo.
Right, yes.
All right, some of the other terminology. Dogging. What is dogging? Now, you wouldn't think that's what it would sound like.
Mm-hmm.
No, you wouldn't.
Uh-huh.
Actually, women and men who go parking in, public areas, public lane type things,
Wait.
The catch is they want.
Wait.
Hold on. Yeah, pull me off one more time. Just pull me off the air one more time. I'm sorry, Russ. Betsy, I will stick this fucking bat up your fucking ass! Now knock it off! Conducting a fucking interview, you cunt! Alright, I'm sorry, Russ. Continue.
Dogging? Okay, yeah. the catch is...
Something funny, Russ?
Oh, no.
All right, continue.
But the catch with dogging is the people in the cars want
stop.
You to look in.
Come on,
at them.
Stop.
So it's actually
guys,
a public performance.
I that. Can't take this.
Right.
I gotta see you guys stop.
Well,
really uncomfortable.
I'm very uncomfortable, and I'm somewhat embarrassed here, Russ. I apologize. You know something? Let's just go to the phones because
there goes that mission. All because of those crashing floors.
Doing fine.
I'm sorry, sir. I'm a little bit nervous. I've never been on the radio before. Hello?
That's okay. That's okay, Steve. You're on with the Rush Kick.
I was looking at a little piece of your thing, and sometimes I like to drink, and I get way too drunk to do any type of functioning or production work, and I wanted to know, why does alcohol sometimes affect my sexual performance?
Look, we're just going to stop.
Anything in your book about alcohol and sex?
A lot of times, because I get yelled at, because a lot of times I'll go out for sushi dinners and I'll just cry inappropriately and I'll just basically cause a problem.
Oh, shut up.
Yeah, well, alcohol is actually known for dampening sexual ability. So.
This story's book is bullshit.
Excuse me?
This guy's circle jerks with children. reading Adam West taste transcripts.
My goodness.
Ramon, this guy has AIDS and is kin to a monkey.
I really want to apologize for our caller. Sometimes they get out of hand, as you can tell, Russ.
I'm gonna hang up on Steve from Yellowstone.
Obviously, that was some type of prank. Prank call.
We get those from time to time. I'm sorry, Russ.
No problem.
I don't know him. Prank caller.
Are nuns and priests having sex? You discussed that in the book. Maybe we should get into that, because that's a hot topic these days.
Well, yes, actually, they are.
Yeah.
Now you're treading on sacred ground, Russ.
Well.
Have you gotten any flack from the church because of this?
No, not yet.
Now, what are they doing? How are they doing it? Where? It doesn't seem like you could just, you know, be in the church.
Well, actually, yes, there is a time-honored tradition of sex in churches.
Really?
Yes.
You know, you're right.
Mm-hmm. But, yeah, there was a survey done in the 70s of nuns and priests.
Yes.
They found out that 15% of them, at least, admitted to actually getting it on while they were nuns and priests.
Yes.
Yes. She seems to know a lot about everything, doesn't she? Professor Betsy, we call her around here. Miss Know-It-All.
Oh, come on.
Yes. Wow, that's fascinating. I never knew that. That is something I didn't know about sex, that priests and nuns.
Well, Tony, the phones have exploded. We got Eric Logan on the line here. Wants to Eric the
Logan?
Russ Kick, the author. Eric.
Hey,
Eric.
Guys, can I talk to the author?
Yeah, you're on.
Hi, Mr. Kick.
On the air.
Hi, I'm Eric from Logan. How are you? Doing fine. You know, I was reading a book about sex, and you know, if you write about sex, people will read it.
Yeah, have you found that the sexual subject really does touch a lot of people? They want to learn more about it.
Well, I hope so.
Get me out of here.
Mr. Greg.
I believe
my
the same caller as the can't get our phone screen properly, then we're gonna have to get a new staff over there, okay? If you couldn't tell that was the same person from earlier, maybe you need to go back to a phone screen or two. I have to apologize.
That was fucking awesome.
For the past few nights, it's been fascinating.
Thank you.
We want to thank you so much for spending a little time with us and sharing everything you know about sex is wrong.
Oh, wait,
just don't just okay. Yeah, in closing, where can we get this book?
Well, it's on Amazon and it's making its way into bookstores across the country.
Do you find that the reaction to it has been, would you say it's a reaction that, like, kind of used to be more expected? It's more on a level of, well, you know, I mean, how much are we supposed to take with this book, whatever it is,
Well, actually, the book is not printed, so I haven't gotten much back at all yet. Except, of course, from your interesting caller there.
When's it go on sale?
Yeah. Now
Betsy's really contributing. Yeah. More than that, asshole. Betsy sometimes was like the fat fucking cop who took her out there. Until she gets indigestion.
Really? I'm out of ammo, and of course I can't get through.
Demolition, but I do know that there were no marks on the front of the Pentagon lawn, and I found that to be disturbing, because how does the official government story
that was
the fact
a
that there
total
are no marks
waste
on the
of a day
with allegedly a plane coming in? That's the problem I have with the government story.
All right, we got anything on that?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, originally the
doing a great job.
Yeah.
Assholes.
Anyway, like I just
I've got to apologize.
This thing slid in.
All right, Corey. Corey.
Yeah, are you going to let me answer the question? The guy asked it.
No, I wouldn't even let you try to work that question out, because that guy that was calling was an idiot.
How about,
Corey,
shut up for a second. We've been having a lot of fun with you, obviously, but we've got some facts out there. So we'll give you the final word like Bill O'Reilly does. To sum up, what would you like to say?
I'd like to say to everybody listening out there that thinks I'm a jerk off or a jackass.
That
I can't believe how many flubs Steve had.
Yeah, Steve can't talk anymore. Steve
just couldn't wait to hammer him.
All right, listen.
Oh, my God. The thought that you, for a split second,
no.
entertained anything on that video, I want to smack that
will
goddamn Breathe strip off your nose. Will you?
As the rule is, when you watch it, you'll see there are a couple of valid points raised. But what happens is, guys like that always sink their own fucking ship because they're agenda-driven and dishonest.
Oh, okay.
That's the problem.
Marge, Long Island, what's up?
Good morning, gentlemen.
Good morning.
Please don't make fun of me.
Why would we with a name like Marge?
When you start out like that.
Okay.
How old are you, Marge?
I'm afraid to tell you.
Oh, don't be scared.
Wait. Let me just say one thing.
Oh.
My belief is that 70 is the new 50.
Hey, you know, so God bless.
70 years young, Madge.
God
70
bless,
years young.
Marge.
But I don't
want
to break what I want you guys to do is to help Little Shelter Animal Adoption Center. We need money
desperately.
And
shelter.
And
wait, what kind of pet do you have?
I have a little poodle.
Does he keep you company, does he?
Yeah, it's better than a man.
I'm far from my home.
By my side all the time, and I don't have to worry that he's straying.
Straying a stray dog, that's funny.
Oh, you're a pit, Marge.
Now, wait a minute. Guys, please listen.
All right, we're listening.
You know, there's going to come a day that you're going to be dead in that bed, and your poodle's going to be nibbling on your arm, right?
Yeah.
Before they find you.
He's gonna grab your wig and run around the house.
Yeah.
Hated it.
Opie,
yeah.
70's the new 50.
But I told you not to make fun of me.
That's Opie. I asked him not to as well.
He's gonna be chewing at that leather skin, waiting for your son to show up from Phoenix to claim the body.
Can I say something, guys?
Wow. Hold on, Marge. We're laughing at your impending death.
Thank you so much. Will you at least put something in the paper?
Hold on, Marge. Wait.
Hold on.
Oh, the dog's not going to have a choice, right?
No.
It's going to eat
go.
The food that was left out.
Fucking cocksucker.
Start eating your wig glue.
I should not have said anything about making fun of me.
Maybe. Like in between the dentures hoping for something.
Probably off to a bad start with the asking not to make fun of you. Yes.
You're right, though. 50 is the new 70. Godspeed.
70 is the new 50.
That way.
As a matter of fact, I'm thinking of doing a TV show called Now and Then.
Right.
And I'm going to have, if maybe you want to help me sell it, but what I'm trying to do is to have people that have had very illustrious careers and are now past 60 years old, do something like be in the news and go back and show people that you don't have to be 30. All right.
Is this the pitch meeting?
How about a great show called Cadaver Calls a Radio Program?
Now, can I talk about Little Shelter?
Go ahead, Mike.
The first thing is that Little Shelter is having we're selling tickets for an Harley raffle.
Nice. Look at you.
Do you want to be the people, the life-saving celebrity couple? You should pardon the expression.
pardoning it.
Sorry.
Because shooter as she runs from the compound.
Will help Little Shelter with the Harley raffle and help find animals' homes. Would you like, can I adopt you, both of you, to be the celebrity spokesperson for hundreds of animals that need homes? Come on, how does it for North Shore Animal League?
No, he doesn't. He's got
blood. I want to give generously to the cattery.
Good.
Yeah, we want to bomb the cattery.
No, you're not bombing.
Actually, we got a animal lover on the phone that wants to talk to Marge from Long Island.
Maybe this guy can help out. It's
Steve from Yellowstone.
Steve from Yellowstone.
You're on with Marge.
Hello, is this Marge?
Yes.
I really love what it is that you're doing for animals. I think it's very important because so many people don't seem to realize that there's a lot of animals out there that are in trouble, and people like to make light of the whole thing, but it really is an important issue.
Bless your heart, Steve.
What's that?
Bless your heart. Would you help me sell some raffles?
The left side of Marge's body should shut down.
Oh, good God.
I want to throw AIDS.
should have called Howard.
I want to rent a small sick dog.
All right. Maybe I'll call Don.
Shut this talking corpse up.
Steve.
Oh, my God.
I hope a sick dog eats pizza at Mars.
Steve. Bag it.
Mama alone. Tell this cat lady to hang herself.
Very nice.
Mama alone. I hope you are
help
not
me, Ozzy. Help
me.
Invasion. Help me.
Mama alone. Shut this irrelevant old bag of meat up.
Very nice.
I just think that a lot of
you
people come to appreciate that they're animals and dribbles.
I'm glad that you
Mama
All right, that'll get you.
Oh, 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 Marge.
Yes.
That was obviously a bad call.
That was a
prank
call
got through our screener.
Yeah, yeah, that happens, you know, all the time.
So, gentlemen, are you with me or against me?
With
again me?
What are we? The Civil War?
Again me?
Yeah.
I'm again you.
What the hell's again?
Again.
Oh.
Auntie.
People give generously to the Little Shelter.
No, what? Buy raffles. Call Little Shelter. 631.
Don't give out any phone numbers.
Go on
our
website.
All right.
Is there any porn on that website?
Yeah, because we can't give out any pornography.
You know, there's a cattery. There's bound to be porn.
Hold on. We do have a real animal lover on the phone. His name is Travis from Riskless Omaha.
All right.
Travis.
Hello.
Yes.
Hi, Travis.
Hi,
I'm sorry. I thought this was my show.
Hi, Marge?
Yes.
I think that a lot of people are going to make fun of you, but I think that what you're doing, I don't want to say anything offensive, it is really God's work, and it's really important because
Thank
there's so
you.
Many sick animals that aren't being taken care of.
That's nice.
See, Marge, we have a heart.
Yeah, and our listeners can be
so
intelligent and...
Torturing small animals is hilarious! Ramon, give me a Viagra so I can walk into the cattery!
All right, listen.
Ramon!
All right, I'm calling Don on
it. Already.
That's it.
Yeah, Marge.
Yes.
Hi, it's Don Imus. Imus in the morning program.
Don, do you remember many years ago when you was with WNBC?
Yeah, back in the days of WNBC.
Yeah. You did a radio broadcast.
I did.
Yeah. You brought in so many adopters. You were wonderful at many years ago.
Yeah.
And I wish you'd come to Little Shelter now and do the same thing.
Doesn't it look like I got an old calico on my head?
Oh.
Yeah. Like a calico cat on my head.
What?
Doesn't my neck look like a scratching post?
I know you really
love my
cat.
Yeah.
Charles, on the other
hand. No, I didn't say I like cats.
I know.
I said something else similar.
I know.
But yeah, I like them young, too.
I know. How's Deirdre?
Just fine. Yeah, dandy.
And what else is doing with your show?
Marge.
I know Opie and Anthony are leading you, making you look terrible.
Why don't you, drop dead.
Yeah. You're not the first person that's told me that.
Yeah. You know, I like to say, 100 is the new 90. Because, I'm old. Hey, Marge, you wearing a cowboy hat? Because
yeah.
I am.
I happen to think that you're a very attractive man.
I happen to think I don't care about you.
I like older men. As you can understand.
Are you with me or again me?
You
jerk.
Don.
You're a jerk.
Thank
Stupid.
You so much.
Shut
Thank
up,
you.
McCord.
All right, Marge, we gotta go.
So are you gonna help, yes or no?
Come on.
Get
a bigger shelter.
Come on.
Little shelter.
Called little.
Called big shelter.
I used to drive past it all the time.
If you help the animals, God is gonna be so good to you.
All right, hold on a line. We'll get some info.
All right.
Yeah, you hold on.
Thank you, doll.
All right, hold on. There goes Marge from Long Island.
Boy, Ramon.
Ramon.
Shit.
Sure got a load of her. All right, we got to take a break. We're so late now. What were we talking about? Oh, the Maury thing and the pickles. Ramon! Hey, Marge.
In the state.
Okay, well, first of all, guys.
Remember Marge, guys, from last week?
Marge from the little shelter out in Northport.
No, Huntington.
Huntington.
Whatever, it's right on the border of Northport.
How are you, Marge?
Warner Road.
First of all.
Yes, Marge.
I have gotten such feedback from everybody.
Well, that's fantastic, Marge.
Gee, come on. Give me 1 second of uninterrupted airtime.
You got it. One.
Do you realize our airtime is worth $5,000 a minute at this point?
That's
it.
I want to know something. If little Shelker could afford it, we would buy it. But
I understand, Marge.
Everybody has said how mean you are.
I'm going to have to call it there.
Wishing me dead.
I really need to get some stuff done for now. Take a break. Blah, blah, blah. You know.
Like dogs and cats and stuff, and one day you're going to be dead in your body, and your little
so let's just drop a little host of Marie to somebody.
And probably nibble on you. Gnawing at one of your limbs because he doesn't have a choice.
Well, that's not the way I heard it, but you know what?
Why, that's better?
What's the matter, Marge?
It's just the little dogs, the little cats need your help so much. The Harley raffle is so important.
What's
you know what I've been doing, guys?
What have you been doing, Marge?
He's offline. Okay. You know my motto that
62. You're 62 years old.
Okay. Here's the deal. I've been actually taking the Harley raffles into bars and trying to get guys to buy it. I've been stopping guys on the street that are on motorcycles and trying to get them to hand out the raffles to somebody else. Now, I'm a woman that has a very, very fine reputation.
Yeah, of course.
And
yes,